Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of our CamTrackAR Masterclass. In the last two episodes, we showed you how to film a scene using CamTrackAR, some of the benefits of the paid versus the free version, and a general overview of the interface itself. In the second episode, we showed you how to take that footage and composite it inside of HitFilm using a pre-rendered CG background. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to take the CamTrackAR data and apply it onto your CG background so that you can export it and composite in HitFilm. Let's first take a look at Blender, which is, of course, free. The first time that you use CamTrackAR data inside of Blender, you have to install the plugin. You only have to do this step once. Come up to Edit, Preferences, and into the Add-on section. Navigate to the CamTrackAR folder. Any take will work, the plugin is included with every single one. Select the Python file and install. Make sure that it's enabled, and then we're ready to go. Here I have a scene set up, using assets from Video Copilot Star Pack and Sketchfab for the mountain. To import the CamTrackAR data, go to File, Import, HitFilm AR Tracking Data. Find the take you want and select the .hfcs file. Select the layer and hit 0 on your number pad to change the point of view to the camera. And there we go, we've now got our virtual camera moving the same way that the real one did on set. It's unlikely that the camera is in exactly the right position, and you can fix that by adjusting the Delta Transform in the settings on the right. This will move the camera but maintain the tracking data. One thing that might be useful is to be able to see your video footage. To do that, come over to the Object Data Properties tab and checkmark Background Images. Add an image, change it to Movie Clip, then open the video file. Change the depth to Front to have the video in front of your 3D scene. Before you export this background, just check in the Output Properties and make sure that everything is correct, including the frame rate. I'll change the resolution to 2560 by 1440. The reason for this is that CamTrackAR records at 1920 by 1440 to give you that extra detail recorded by the camera. So our 3D render needs to match the height of 1440 plus have extra on the sides if we want to stay in the 16:9 aspect ratio. Pick the folder it'll be exported to. In this case, it's a PNG sequence. Now come up to Render and select Render Animation. Now let's learn how to use the data inside of Unreal Engine 4, which is also free. Here I have a Polar Facility map, which is available on the Epic Games Marketplace. Let's start by coming up to Cinematics and then selecting Add Level Sequence. This will open up the sequencer timeline. Come over to the Actions icon, select Import, and navigate to the CamTrackAR folder. The FBX file is the one we want. Uncheck everything except Create Cameras and hit Import. Be sure to change it to 60 FPS because it might default to 30. You can extend the view range with these numbers down here. You'll also want to move the out point, which is this red line, and extend the length of the camera itself to cover the whole timeline. This button here will lock the viewport to the camera's view so that you can see the movement. Like we did in Blender, we'll want to move the position of the camera to be in the correct spot. I'll drag an empty actor into my scene and zero out its position in the Details panel. In the World Outliner, drag the AR camera on top of the empty actor to parent the former to it. We can now use this empty actor to move the camera around and maintain the tracking data. I'll align the actor with the floor of my scene, as that's quite important to get right. Select the AR camera and come into the Details panel. Change the film back to 48 height and 27 width. This matches the 16:9 aspect ratio we'll end up going for in the composite. Now we're ready to export. Click the Render button in the timeline. I'll leave it as AVI, but we'll want to change the resolution to 2560 by 1440. This is to match the film back setting we changed earlier. Then I can click Capture Movie and my scene will be exported. Even though After Effects is not a traditional 3D program, we did want to show you how to use it since it's part of the paid options. For import into After Effects, what you're going to want to do is go to File, Scripts, Run Script File, and open the .jsx file to create a new composition with the footage imported as well. And as easy as that, you have your footage and your tracked camera. Any anchor points will come in as null objects. We don't do a lot of After Effects tutorials on this channel, so I'll leave that there. If you're interested in seeing how to composite it in a 2D video, check out the previous tutorial. Once the background has been exported from your program of choice, you're free to do whatever you like with it. In the last tutorial, we showed you how to composite it with a green screen clip inside of HitFilm, so be sure to check that out. We hope you guys have enjoyed this CamTrackAR Masterclass. Be sure to check out the app for free on the iOS App Store. If you have any questions or comments or requests for longer tutorials on a specific step, feel free to leave them down below. Be sure to subscribe for weekly filmmaking and visual effects tutorials, and I'll see you all in the next video.